Hello, I'm Ricky R. Lavon, author of the book Work for the Lord is with You. In this video, I will read the Just a Thought portion from the lesson 4 of the book. If you want to take notes, then make sure to get the proper implements to write. Each lesson in this book has this section at the end. Please enjoy and have a great day. During Haggai's time, the former exiled people decided it was their best interest to do their own thing. God made a decree through the Persian leader to return to Jerusalem and rebuild his temple. The people heard this call, went back to the city, and chose to rebuild their homes and leave God's house in ruins. The gap in time was roughly 8 to 10 years when God sent Haggai to inform them of their error and ways. This behavior is not only true then, but can happen in the modern day as well. God can give his people a call to do something for him. For churches, it could be helping the community in the best possible way. Individuals might be called to do a specific act, use a talent, or even help a church with this mission for the Lord. Whatever it might be, God has a plan for everyone. And he is setting people to transition from one aspect of their life to a higher calling. Like the ancient Israelites, many of us feel like we've been exiled from comfortable living to one of confusion or nightmare. Many organizations, churches, and people might go through a dreadful situation that will cause muddled emotions or rather they're on the right path. It's within these dark periods of our life that we learn to listen to God and love Him despite the circumstances. The Lord wants us to fulfill His call. But sometimes we decide to do things our way. In these moments, the Lord has to lay out the truth and, of course, correction. As you read from this lesson, Paul reminded the people in Rome of the dangers of breaking away from God. Paul was referring to those who knew the Lord and had a relationship with Him, but chose differently. Because although they knew God, they did not glorify Him as God, nor were thankful, but became futile in their thoughts, and their foolish hearts were darkened. That's from Romans chapter 1, verse 21. From this text, Paul was clear in that the people he was referring to knew about God. The characteristics that follow this statement are usually attributed to people we associate with non-believer, heathens, worldly, or others who do not have a relationship with God. Nevertheless, from this scripture, we can see that countless believers know God but do not follow His teaching or words. After verse 21, Paul lists a cornucopia number of sins and defects that plagues these pseudo-believers and how they infect others who are willing to hear. The same can go for the modern-day Christian. Many people in the 21st century know God but do not glorify Him or recognize His authority. They know that God exists and have no problem stating this fact. Nevertheless, with their actions, they do not represent Him by showing love to others, obey His commands, or use the Bible as a means to bring people to God. Some places use God as a weapon to spread their beliefs, but conveniently forget Him when it doesn't fit their purpose. Often some go to church, listen to songs, give money, and hear a sermon. Then when the question is asked regarding what they learn, there is a blank stare and a response akin to, "I don't know, but it was a good service." Now, just think about how that sounds. If you went to a restaurant and someone asked, "What did you eat?" 3 minutes after you left, I'm pretty sure you at least remember something you consumed. Now, when speaking about those who did not recognize God and Haggai talking to the people not obeying the Lord, Paul enlightened the people of their time to a single fact. Knowing that God exists is important. It's great knowing that you believe in a higher power. However, it's more important to not only believe, but obey Him as well. After all, even Satan and his followers believe that God exists, but choose disobedience. Does anyone who claims to love God wants to follow in the footsteps of Satan? Thank you once again for your support of this book. Hope you really enjoy work for the Lord. It's with you. Please make sure to go out and get a copy today if you do not already have one. And thank you. Have a blessed day and enjoy yourself.